back at it again. We defeated the alias monster. Oh, wait, no. We defeated the Nevi. We defeated the alias in the episode before last.
Yeah, the Nevi took over the industrial complex. And now we've put it back in the hands of the people, where it belongs.
Right.
With the proletariat.
Finally, communism comes to Hexville.
That's where it belongs.
Right.
But also, we met that we met the military.
Oh, yeah.
And there's that lady with the gun on her arm.
Yeah, like the Merger Man.
Yeah, like Megas Man.
Yeah, like Mr. Number 9.
I love that guy. And did I see that we could take the train?
We can take yet another train.
I'd like to take the A train.
Still no pets allowed, though.
I can't believe this. We have saved your city twice over. Maybe more. Three times now, huh?
Look, if they bend the rules for us, they're gonna have to do it for everybody.
I guess so. They can't just be for heroes.
So we get a nice view of the cities of the Hexville. And whoa, would you look at that?
I like that the, like, distance color is different for each center.
Oh, yeah.
So, like, you saw the fade from yellow to green, and it gives, like, a... It's very subtle in a way that it gives these identities to these areas.
Yeah, it gives off a nice atmosphere to each of the areas.
Yeah, totally.
Oh! Oh, yeah! Chewie! Owie!
That was a very long voice line for what seemed like a very short...
I assume because the whole thing was, hey, hey cat, hey, cat, hey, hey cat.
Hey, ha-ha, it's me, Gade.
Whoa. Oh, well, okay. Bye, I guess.
Ugh, who'd ever want to go back to a rift plane?
Yeah, jeez. We already took all their gems. But it looks like all kinds of changes are happening around here.
Yeah. And hey, look, there's a new mission.
Oh, I love those.
So we'll explore the town right after we do this one.
Yeah, for sure.
This is a really nice part of town. Just like it's got like that old New York feel to it.
Yeah, and the music kind of gives that off too. That's another thing that's really cool about each area is their like music kind of plays into what they're about. Because like the entertainment district was kind of this fast, fun, jazzy thing. There were a lot of, like, industrial noises when we went to, like, the factory area. And this one just got, like, a nice, quaint feel.
Yeah, and the first area has ska.
Well, yeah. Because it's cool.
Right.
It's the coolest.
There's a fountain?
Yeah!
There's a boy peeing, and that's part of the fountain?
There's a fortune teller?
Man, let's just go back there, honestly.
Yeah, forget this lady and her lettered word boyfriend.
All right. Ugh.
Ugh, romance. I don't have any, so why should other people be happy? But Kat's not like that. Kat's a better person.
No, Kat's actually gonna find the letter and rip it up.
And be like, I'm your girlfriend now. I'm giving you this letter. Oh, wow, we're going down far.
Yeah.
I think usually when we drop this far, it tends to be like an insta-kill, but this goes pretty deep.
Right. We just get sucked into a big old gravity storm.
Yeah.
But I guess the weather is nice today.
Yeah, it does look pretty nice. And full of gems.
Yeah, this is the kind of day that you'd go for a picnic or something.
Right. We don't have anyone to go on a picnic with, except for Dusty. So it wouldn't be quite the same.
No.
Man, this... She really dropped her letter.
Yeah. She dropped it so far that the music isn't playing anymore.
Oh. Ooh. That's a little ominous.
Hey, this is a quick mission. Once we're done with this, then we can do some of those side stuff. That will be fun.
Hey, totally. Man, your girlfriend is so clumsy that when she drops her letter, she really drops her letter.
Your girlfriend is so clumsy when she sits around the house, she really sits around the house.
If you get what I mean, and I don't. Oh, you mean this weird organic tunnel? Oh my goodness. Wait, what? Uh-oh.
What? Oh, that's my thing, though. Without that, the game's just a rush. And I can't go very fast without it.
Yeah, that band's old. Who even likes them these days?
Don't say anything bad about Neil Peart or Perk or Mr. Drummer Man.
Right, or Geddy Lee, the bassist, or the guitarist who no one knows.
If he was in this game, he'd be Neil Pierre, because that's a French name.
Right.
Don't say anything bad about Sting, the guitarist for the band Rush.
Oh, okay. I think it's cool that you can, like, go down very slowly and deliberately and collect all these gems that kind of lead you nicely down fairly harmless. But also, you could just free flow.
Yeah, who's got time? Look at this video. It's 30 minutes long.
Yeah, we've got so much to take care of. How could we possibly stop for all these gems that you're sure to get off screen? Oh my god.
Oh yeah. Don't worry, the bonus video is just gonna be nothing but me collecting gems.
It's gonna be you doing this flawlessly and restarting every time you miss a single gem.
Right. I'm gonna get an S rank.
Gonna do some kickflips. Some indie nose bones. Some other tricks.
Yeah. The 360 Christ Air Budapest Hotel.
Yep. The Days of Future Past.
The Still Rushing. The
Shatterhand.
The Zoo Ranger.
Okay, we got our gravity powers back.
Oh, yeah, that's nice.
Yeah.
I love those things.
Man, we're still falling, huh? Like,
yeah,
I
but now it's a controlled fall.
Oh, okay. Because I assumed that tunnel was basically just a detour and we're just farther down than ever before. Because we dropped a lot.
We've got a lot in common with these enemies because we're both going down.
You are right. And thankfully, these flying ones don't seem to be as annoying as they have been previously. Maybe because there's really only one at a time.
Yeah, they're just kind of doing their thing.
You know, live and let live. That's what I say. Cat's a humanitarian.
Like, this just big dotted line of gems feels like a little Jimmy ran through here from the family circus.
Billy.
Right, that's what I said.
Yeah.
Little Billy.
Oh, so we're just like, oh, I see, so we're avoiding the storms.
Yeah.
I guess this is one way to do it.
You don't want to get caught out in the rain.
Yeah.
The gravity rain. Sucks that we can't shift while we're in this giant bone zone.
Yeah.
But not that kind of bone zone.
Right. We mean literally bones.
Yes.
But what are these bones from? Is kind of my big question. Like, these are very large expansive bones.
The pillar is a giant spine.
Oh. It's like that show.
Giant spine?
No.
What? Bones?
Yes. Yep, that's what I'm talking about. It's Bones, that popular series about giant bone structures and the people who fall down them.
They solve all the mysteries by just grabbing a giant bone and beating the criminals with them.
I'm a detective who can only solve mysteries if I'm free-falling. I have psychic powers that only happen.
Isn't that the new Sweary novel?
Yeah, that's the one. That's funny because his actual new book is about cats. And as we know from Gravity Rush, we love cats.
Oh, yeah.
And cat.
Cat's my favorite cat.
Yeah. She's a cat who knows where it's at. And it's approximately 30 yards away.
Right. She knows what's new.
Whoa. Yeah, thank you.
We're halfway there. Whoa.
hey, wait a minute. That's not the same thing. Goodness gracious. You think she could have told us a little earlier that it had fallen, so we didn't have to do all this extra work? We could have caught it ahead of time. Lord, these teeth? Gross.
Well, I don't know. It's not like when something falls, you can catch up to it.
Oh, maybe not. I mean, we can fall faster than gravity using our powers, but...
I feel like we fall around the speed of gravity.
Well, you have a fast fall, though.
Yeah, but that's... I mean, you have a fast fall when you're skydiving. That's called, like, putting your arms next to your body.
You're right. But this one's supernatural.
And I was gonna just follow the trail, but now I'm just... No, I gotta get those tasty gems.
Yeah. Yum, yum, yum.
Just like Pac-Man.
Yeah, that's what he's like. He's like, yum, yum, yum. Gotta feed him to Dusty.
I must make my precious little kitty boy strong.
Where are you going? You're just like circling.
Yeah, I'm just heading for the thing now.
Just enjoying the sights.
Yeah.
Showing off all 360 degrees of this game.
Let's take a 360 look at the PlayStation 4.
In VR.
Xbox One.
Yep.
Now let's switch to a new room.
Oh! Do we get to shift gravity this time?
Finally.
Awesome. But wait a minute. Oh, it's just pointing to the things outside. Never mind. I thought it was pointing straight up, and there was something to be there.
That would have been scary. Like
I'm
this.
Not gonna lie. Whoa. I'm not gonna lie. She's a lot more graceful than you are when playing this game. Oh, no.
That's because she's cheating. She's using cutscene.
Uh-oh.
Ah, this girl again. Woof, Adilfa.
Jeez. Raven's always getting in our way.
She's more like a raven lunatic, if you ask me.
You are right.
Ah, jeez, we got a long way to go.
Oh, man, and she might attack us on the way there. Oh, no!
If I fall fast enough, she can't catch up to me.
Good thing you increased your fall speed. Oh no, she got in front of you. Wait, look at all those gems. No, you're missing them.
I'm trying. No, she's throwing stuff at me.
I'm sorry.
There we go.
What does she mean trying to ruin things? We've just been helping the town. More than she's done.
Maybe we're secretly destroying the economy.
Or there's like a second town underneath this town, like on the underside that only exists in the other dimension.
No, I think we're just like causing inflation because there's way more money now.
Oh, okay. Oh no, there's too much the money in our world.
when the parts of the town disappeared, we started the mint back up.
This is like a really weird first-person shmup right now, with her tossing stuff at us.
Yeah.
Also, you're not looking so hot.
No. Hey, I'm always hot.
Okay.
But yeah, it's a little bit hard to tell, like, how close you are to the projectiles. You know, the yep. projectiles. The projectiles.
Yeah, it seems like it's a little hard to do that, and it's more like you just gotta keep being ready to move when she pops up.
Yeah.
But it is a neat kind of section, because it's just a different thing.
Yeah.
It's a lot more about avoidance than fighting.
But it does make me wish that I could fall forward while still dodging.
Oh, can you not move while you're fast falling?
Well, like, you can dodge, but it sort of, like, halts your momentum, and...
Yeah, and movement just is a little, like, weird while you're doing gravity in general.
Yeah. And when you're...
Oh, whoa!
Ah, I figured out. This is what I was trying to do the other time, but I accidentally did the black hole.
Oh, you can wallop her projectiles.
Yeah. Oh, that's no. Neat. Oh, she's got another projectile.
Not another one.
Sounds pretty ballsy to me.
Where's she in the script compared to us? I feel like she may have read ahead. The children? No, we've saved children.
Cat is friend to children.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna go through that hole real quick.
Go quick, no! Yes! You did it. Expert play.
Didn't get hit once.
Now I see why you're the one LPing. Goodness gracious.
Oh, that looks bad.
There's still more. That did not sound good.
Yeah, Raven, don't just leave me in the dark, like with the darkness swallowing our world.
What?
Shuyonju Mashu. Loduru plans mashi plan. Polela losa la shuju. Bensu onse lavlan. Noval anduvi. Polela koa kinua du tuleali bima unsav.
Oh, no. They can't send me back. I won't go back to prison. Attica! Attica!
Oh, wow. These kids are like little goblins.
Hey, that's all kids.
Hey.
Can't believe they were able to capture us in the punishment orb.
Oh wow, I wonder which of these children is important. Okay, to be fair to that kid, that is a cool mask.
Damn.
But man, this is not going well.
Hey, I'm supposed to be banging on the bars.
God, what a dick. This Birdman.
Yeah, what I need is a Birdman attorney at law.
Oh, whoops.
And I shook the screen a little bit there just to add some ambience.
Oh, that was good.
Kids will never understand.
Kids these days. They're too busy thinking about themselves and their iPhones. Oh, yeah, like the color of her hair.
Oh, yeah. She looks like Hatsune Miku.
Just like her.
Mm-hmm. Can't tell the difference.
That's how you know she's important.
Ugh, millennials just want to take their naps and not watch Prisoners.
Oh, they're so lazy. No wonder they're killing the prison industrial complex. I like the little bit of added physics to this. It's nice as a touch.
I wish you'd just play the whole rest of the game in Super Monkey Ball mode.
I was just going to say that there should be at least a section where you have to roll around in the cage to find something to open it.
Oh no, look out, that pretty lady is getting away.
Wow, look out, this hot and incredibly single woman is on the loose. I hear she has great taste as well.
Oh no.
Oh, uh-oh, it's a stealth mission. Kinda.
Everybody's favorite.
But I think one nice thing about the stealth missions in Gravity Rush is, like, you don't really have to stealth around things, you just find alternative routes.
Right.
Like, as previously we did, and this one is just kind of, like, forcing you to kind of learn how this whole town's built.
Yeah, I don't know, there's a bit of stealth. Like, I gotta wait for this kid or else he'll hit me with his big pipe.
Right, which is fucked up. But still, like, the actual, like, stealth mechanics are minimal. And that's appreciated because appreciated in the way that, like, there are some games that force in, like, very in-depth stealth missions that just don't fit the mechanics.
But I don't know.
This one is simplistic enough not to be an issue, or at least as much of one.
I feel like I could take these kids.
Maybe. Maybe, well, I think you might need Dusty. They have weapons.
I don't know. Have you seen these legs? These are the weapon.
Like when you go through airport security?
Yeah, they...
It's like, sorry, my legs are registered weapons.
I can't wear pants because, I can't,
Concealed weapons.
Concealed weapon, right.
Just edit that joke to make it sound like you said it, and then I was the idiot.
I'm Chopsway. I don't know how words work.
Hey, Chops, what kind of words are you making? Real ones? Oh, uh-oh. Oh no!
Oh, I thought she was really scared that the prisoner escaped for a second.
We fought this Ridley-ass motherfucker at the tech place when Dusty was having some troubles.
Yeah.
Some tum-tum troubles. And thank goodness, Dusty came back just in time.
I don't know, I could have taken her.
What a good cat.
Oh wait, are we not fighting the little girl? Oh, never mind.
I could have taken on Cyania.
Sciatica.
Just watch as I beat up this actual child. She ain't got shit on me.
What you gonna do, fall asleep?
Wow, that was really quick. I feel like the first time I tried to do this, I did it all with kicks, and that was very annoying.
See, that's why I'm driving.
Yeah, you're the smart elf here.
Yeah, and so help me, I will turn this Let's Play around. Start playing it backwards.
And welcome to Gravity Rush.
Rush Gravity and 2. Welcome.
Wow, there are all kinds of Nevi here, and they weren't here before.
How do you know?
Well, I guess so.
We barely saw any of this town.
Yeah, you're right.
These could be the residents.
They could have just been hiding. They could have all been down at the pub getting a brew.
I heard the Nevis are playing tonight, and they're fighting the Nevis.
Oh, whoa. I love that band. And that wrestling troupe.
I love their improv.
And I hear they can cook a mean casserole.
More like an acerole hole.
Wow. Wow, but you're right, probably. Oh, that was a good landing.
And that dog is going crazy.
Hey, I mean, I would be going crazy if I saw the Nevi.
Oh, yeah, no. Your brain can't handle it. It's like amnesia. The Dork Descent.
I can't believe it protected its eye with its huge butt when you were throwing that barrel at it. Now that's a resourceful little Nevi.
He's got a big butt and he cannot eye.
Yeah. Also, he can't lie. It's impossible for him. That's a Nevi thing.
Yeah. Unfortunately, Nevis never speak, so they don't really show that off.
Right. Well, some Nevis always tell the truth and some always tell lies. And some of them tell you assorted facts from random Wikipedia.
And they're like, oh, Kat, you're so beautiful. And it's like, ah. Oh.
Shit, I can't tell which one because they might be sarcastic.
Do you think that that's part of the gatekeeper riddle? Is that one of them is always really sarcastic and that's how you figure it out?
One of them's a jackass.
Oh, no, I don't think you should go through his door. Whoa.
One of them always tells the truth and one of them is very passive aggressive.
One of them always tells the truth and the other is racist. Like, woof.
Like, really racist.
Do not invite him to a party. One of them always tells the truth and the other makes Let's Plays.
One always tells the truth and one of them will just constantly tell you about how Mexican Coke is better than regular Coke because they use real cane sugar in there. It's a lot better.
Yeah. And that shark man was just hanging out in the void.
Well,
he's a cool dude. Look, we can all relate to void sharks sometimes.
It's true. Like at the Super Bowl.
Look, Chorps, that's old memes now.
Sorry, I need to move on to the new wholesome memes.
Right.
Anyways, I'm glad that, like, they're willing to, like, you know, talk to us and not be bad people to us now that we've done something for them.
Yeah. This kid's van is pretty sick, though.
Yeah, this guy's cool. I thought that whole hair bit was part of his mask. He just has kind of cool hair.
And, like, it was always like that, apparently, even before he became, like, a tribal leader.
Yeah, it looks like he got more hair in between. Like, it's just bigger.
Yeah. It's like he's trying to, like, masquerade a Karibo as a hair.
He kind of looks like a Samurai Champloo OC.
This character is Tugen. He's like Mugen times two.
Double the hair. Double the attitude.
And since we can't go to our beautiful pipe home, we can just hang out in this bus.
Oh, hey, kid.
Not as much fun.
Yeah, we can't even change outfits here.
I mean, would you want to change in front of this kid?
I guess you're right.
But you might recognize this bus because they talked about it earlier in the game.
Oh, right.
When we were at the school.
They talked about that bus of kids.
Yeah.
I assume these are the kids.
Oh, that's nice that their mom and dad send food.
Huh, and...
Oh.
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 Oh. Well, now I'm depressed.
I love half-eaten Hot Pockets. It's my favorite, Mom.
Well, maybe the rich people down there are throwing out, like, whole turkeys, because they're slightly overcooked.
Well, wait, think that there's just one place that Hexaville dumps all the trash, even though they could just throw it all off the edge?
I think that that trash compactor is hiding some secrets.
Yeah, why do they even need to compact the trash?
Well, because they compact it and then it falls down here.
Oh, do you think Alias fell down here? And they're like, oh, let's eat him.
Hey, you know?
When in Rome.